Welcome to GradUp. So this is the most awaited session, and now we are going to discuss all the questions which were prepared by IIM Indore. All right, so you can say they are the most expected questions of quant. So today is the first part, so I welcome you all in this session. So before we start, please be quick and mark your presence. Everyone, please be quick and mark your presence. Okay, so let's start. So in question number, so first of all, let me introduce myself. I am Ajay Sareen. I am quant and DILR expert, having experience of 16 plus years for teaching students for CAT, GMAT and GRE and other competitive exams. I am a 100 percentiler in quant and DI section of CAT 2014, and till date I have mentored more than 30,000 students. So CAT 2020 final revision with GradUp, which is we are conducting right now. So you can always check out the entire series playlist for complete last minute preparation. Most expected questions covered for quant, VARC and DILR. Mock test analysis will be there. Day-wise revision of all important topics will be there. Strategy to attempt the exam, questions from IIM Indore. And these sessions will take place every day at 5:30, 7 p.m. and 9 p.m. So please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Good evening, and stay tuned to GradUp. Good evening, good evening, good evening. Hi, Riti. So another important announcement for all the students: CAT 2020 exam analysis will be live on 29th of November 2020. Students who are appearing in shift one can attend the analysis starting at 10:45 a.m. Students appearing in shift 2 can attend the session starting at 2:45 p.m. And students of third shift can attend the session at 6:45 p.m. You just need to subscribe to our channel and stay tuned to GradUp. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. So let's start with question number one. Here he says a red light flashes 3 times per minute. So can I say a red light will flash after every 20 seconds? Green light flashes 4 times per minute. So green light will flash every 15 seconds. Because 60 by 3 is 20, 60 by 4 is 15. And yellow light flashes 6 times per minute at regular intervals. So 60 by 6 comes out to be after every 10 second yellow light will flash. If all three lights start flashing at the same time, how many times do they flash together in each 75 minutes? In order to solve it, we need to find after what time all three of them will flash together. That comes out to be the LCM of the three numbers, which is 20, 15 and 10. So LCM of these three values comes out to be, this is 4 into 5, this is 3 into 5, this is 2 into 5. So LCM will be 4 into 5 into 3, which is 60 seconds, which comes out to be 1 minute. So in each 75 minutes, can I say it will flash for a total of 75 times? So guys, please check it out. A very, very easy question. Good evening, good evening. Based on the concept of LCM. All right, so we just need to find the time after which all three of them will flash together. Naved, I hope this part is clear. I hope you have joined a bit late. So please read the information carefully. Red light flashes 3 times per minute, so it will flash after every 20 seconds. Green light flashes 4 times per minute, so it will flash after every 15 seconds. Yellow light flashes 6 times per minute, so it will flash every 10 seconds. So all three of them will flash together when time is a common multiple of 20, 15, 10. So we need to find their LCM, which comes out to be 60 seconds, which is 1 minute. So in each 75 minutes, they will be flashing together for 75 times. Is it done, Naved? Okay, so let's move on. A bag contains a total of 105 points of rupee 1, 50 paisa and 25 paisa denominations. Find the total number of rupee 1 points if there are a total of 50.50 rupees in the bag. And it is known that number of 25 paisa coins is 133.33% more than the number of rupee 1 coins. So guys, 133.33 is 4 by 3 more. It means the multiplying factor will be 1 plus 4 by 3, which is 7 by 3. So if the rupee 1 coins are 3x in number, so 25 paisa coins will be 7x in number. Because 7 by 3 of 3x comes out to be 7x. Let's assume 50 paisa coins are by in number. So we are given that the total number of coins are 105. So we can say 3x plus y plus 7x, which adds up to 10x plus y equal 105. On the other side, total amount is known to me, which is 50.5 rupees. So if we have 3x coins of rupee 1, so total amount will be rupee 3x. If there are y coins of 50 paisa, amount in rupees will be y by 2. And if there are 7x coins of 25 paisa, amount in rupees must be 7x by 4, which equals 50.5. Now let's simplify left hand side and multiply throughout by 4. So 4 3 is 12, 12 plus 7 comes out to be 19x plus 2y equal 50.5 into 4. So 4 5 is 20 and 4 5 is 20, right hand side becomes 202. As we are required number of 1 rupee coins, so we are required the value of x. So let's multiply equation 1 by 2 and subtract these two equations. So 2y, 2y get cancelled out. 20x minus 19x is x. And 105 into 2 is 210 minus 202 comes out to be 8. So number of rupee 1 coins will be 3 into 8, which is equivalent to 24. So the correct answer option is C. Good, Priya. So guys, please check it out. I hope it is clear to each and every student. If any student has a doubt, please let me know. Rohit, I am just, can you be specific which part is a concern area for you? Varun? Because I will explain that particular part, or you want me to complete entire again. Okay, so here it is given to me, it is known that number of 25 paisa coins is 133.33% more than the number of rupee 1 coins. So 133.33 in P by Q form is 4 by 3. As he say, it is more, this percent more than, right? It means the multiplying factor will be 1 plus 4 by 3. I am using multiplying factor here. I hope you are aware with the basic concept of percentage, wherein we use multiplying factor. Jacinth, I am using multiplying factor. So we have discussed it in the class of percentage. So if there is a value x which is increased by a percent, so the result becomes x plus a percent of x. Or if I take x common, it becomes 1 plus a percent into x. So this is called multiplying factor. Manoj, refresh your window. Jacinth, Varun, is it clear? Manoj, you need to refresh your window. Okay, so let's move on. In question number 3, he says a bag has 6 blue balls So blue balls are section number, 8 red balls, 5 black balls, and 9 white balls. You are asked to pick some balls from the bag without looking into the bag. What is the minimum number of balls you must pick so as to be sure that at least 3 of them are of the same color? Now guys, let's say if I take a number like 4, right? If you take 4 balls out of the bag, there is a possibility that you have just picked one ball of each type, right? So if you have picked two balls of each type, which means you have picked a total of 8 balls from the bag, still we are not sure that we have picked at least 3 of them that are of same color, right? So the moment you will pick one more ball, right? If you will pick one more ball, it can be of blue color, which makes it 3, or it can be of red color, which will make it 3, or it can be of black color, which makes it 3, or it can be of white color, which makes it 3, right? So koi na koi to aapka 3 ho hi jayega the moment you will pick one more. So the answer in this case comes out to be 9. So guys, please check it out. It is a very, very, very important question and concept. And I always stress a lot on this particular case when such a scenario is given to me, where he says at least 3 of them should be of same color. Just pick 2 from all the categories. The moment you will pick one more, it will ensure that at least 3 of them are of the same color. I hope it is clear to each and every student. Now guys, you have to be very quick with the response, yes or no, but you have to be very quick. Right. So the way you will respond accordingly, I can move on to next questions quickly. Right. Good. So let's move on. Right. Here it says, x square plus x plus 1 upon x plus 1 equal x upon a plus 1. X is real if. So whenever such a scenario is given to me and question says x is real and there is some unknown variable whose range is to be found. And now we know whenever x is real, discriminant is always greater than equal to 0. In order to study discriminant of this equation, we have to simplify it. So let's multiply with a plus 1 and x plus 1, which means let's cross multiply. So it becomes a plus 1 into x square plus a plus 1 into x plus a plus 1. So I multiplied a plus 1 with all the 3 terms separately. And here it will be x square plus x. So which when brought to the left hand side makes it minus x square minus x equal to 0. Now when you will take x square common out of these two, a plus 1 minus 1 gives me ax square. When we take x common out of these two, a plus 1 minus 1 gives me a into x plus a plus 1 equals 0. So if discriminant is greater than equal to 0, that will be b square minus 4 into a into c is greater than equal to 0. So we just need to simplify it. So let's open the bracket. So a square minus 4a square minus 4a is greater than equal to 0. So this gives me minus 3a square minus 4a greater than equal to 0. So let's multiply both sides by minus 1 and take a common. So it becomes a into 3a minus 4 will be less than equal to 0. Because when we multiply with minus 1 both sides, the sign of inequality will change. Instead of greater than equal to, now it is less than equal to. And the solution for this inequality will be a in the range 0 to 4 by 3. So the correct answer option comes out to be a is less than equal to 4 by 3, a is greater than equal to 0, which is option A. Discriminant is b square minus 4ac. That's why this 4 is coming in the picture. Is it done, Shivani? Oh, sorry, 3a plus 4. Right. This is 3a plus 4. So it will be minus 4 by 3. So not a. C will be the correct answer option. Right. So I just wrote negative sign. My mistake. Right, Nitesh. It's fine. Right, Sagar. Kajal, kar diya. That was just a mistake. वो ध्यान नहीं रहा और नीचे से डाटा ऊपर लेके गया आप तो जल्दबाजी में हो गया काजल कर दिया डेट वाज जस्ट अ मिस्टेक वो इज इट डन ओके सो लेट्स मूव ऑन नाउ हियर इट सेज एन एम्प्टी मेटल कंटेनर विदाउट इट्स हैंडल सो देयर इज एन एम्प्टी मेटल कंटेनर And there is some handle attached to it, but right now he talks about only empty metal container. An empty metal container weight 15% of its weight when filled with a particular liquid. Right, so it must be weigh. There is some issue with the language. Okay, so when it is filled with certain liquid, all right, so whatever the weight of this is, right, so let's say if the weight is of x, so weight of this empty container will be 15%, which is 0.15x. Then he says after adding the handle, the weight of fully filled container increases by 5%. After adding the handle, so let's say if I add a handle here, so the weight of this will increase by 5%. So now it will be 1.05x. If the weight of a partly filled container is 1/3 of the completely filled container with handle attached. So there is another case now. So now this is the partly filled handle, partly filled container. So when we weigh it, its weight along with handle is 1/3 of this value. So its 1/3 comes out to be 3 threes are 9, 3 fives are 15, which is 0.35x. Then he says, then what fraction of container is utilized? We need to find the fraction of container that is being utilized. So the capacity of the container is x. Please keep that in mind. All right, so if x liter was filled, then weight of this empty was 0.15x. So I'm just going to rewrite all the equations so that each and everything is now clear to each one of you, even in a better way. So if I fill a liquid, an empty metal container weigh 15% of its weight when filled with a particular liquid. So if I fill it with a particular liquid, so let's say the weight of liquid is x, right? And the weight of container is some value, all right? So, or we can take the entire weight of container plus liquid to be x. So given to me is the weight of empty metal container is 15% of x, so this value is 0.15x, which means weight of container is 0.15x and the weight of liquid comes out to be x minus 0.15x, which is 0.85x. After adding the handle, the weight of the fully filled container increases by 5%. So when you add the handle here, its weight increases by 5%. Now, the weight of container plus liquid plus handle comes out to be 1.05x. So we already know that the weights of these two is x. So the weight of handle must be another 0.05x. Now he says, if the weight of a partly filled container is 1 by 3 of the completely filled container with attached handle. Now in this case, it is given to me that this is the case, right? So its weight is 1.05x. And now there is a partly filled container with attached handle. And its weight is 1/3 of this, which is 0.35x. Then he says, but fraction of container is utilized. So in this case, in first case, the quantity of liquid is 0.85x, which will be your base. In this case, out of this, we will subtract the weight of container, the weight of handle, which adds up to 0.20x. So leftover will be the weight of liquid, which comes out to be 0.15x. So he is asking 0.15x is what fraction of 0.85x. So x and x get cancelled out. 5 3s are 15, 5 17s are 85. So answer comes out to be 3 by 17. So please check it out, right, Riti, right, Priya. So please, guys, check it out. So this will be a better, crisp and clear way of doing it. So each and everything I have mentioned now clearly. Is it done? Harish, which part now each and everything is written there? Which part you want me to repeat? Please specify. That way it will be easier for you also to understand. Ayush, I am asking Harish. Yeah, the language is tricky. So we need to reread it. So usually I do solve questions in just one reading. But in this case, so that it becomes easy for you guys to comprehend, I have to rewrite each and everything here. So the first thing here is the weight of the container and liquid. I assumed it to be X. He says weight of the empty container without handle is 15% of its weight when filled with a particular liquid. So the weight of container is 0.15x, which gives me weight of the liquid initially is x minus 0.15x, which is 0.85x. After adding the handle, the weight of the fully filled container increases by 5%, right? Which means the increase is of the weight of handle only. But I still wrote the equation that now weight of container plus liquid plus handle will be 5% more than this, which is 1.05x. Because they add up to x, so the weight of handle will be 1.05 minus 1, which is 0.05x. Is it clear, Harish? Right, Manoj. Vignesh, is it done? Yahan tak clear hai? Right. Vignesh, I hope this much part is clear. Right, Harish, right. I am asking Vignesh. So after this, he says, if the weight of a partly filled container is 1/3 of the completely filled container with handle attached. So its weight is 1.05x. Now weight of this container given to me is 0.35x. It is 1/3 of 1.05x. So 3 3s are 9, 3 5s are 15, gives me 0.35x. He is asking what fraction of container is utilized. So we need to find the weight of liquid in both the cases. In first case, when it is completely full, the weight of liquid is 0.85x. So in second case, we need to subtract the weight of container and handle out of this, which is 0.20x. So weight of liquid in this container is only 0.15 and fully filled is 0.85. So dividing these two will give us the answer. Right. Good job. Good. Okay. So let's move on. In 60 says 1 kilogram of laddu mix packet cost rupee 150 usually and can be used to make 100 laddus. A festive offer is launched with 20% extra material in each packet and at 10% price discount. Last month, Ram bought N of packets to make 6,000 laddus. So let's talk about Ram first. So Ram made a total of 6,000 laddus when no offer was available, right? So it means 1 kg of laddu mix can be used to make 100 laddus. So for 6,000 laddus, he must have purchased 60 packets. And if packet cost of each packet is 150, 60 packets must have costed him 60 into 150, which comes out to be a total of 9,000. Right. Then he says, this month during the festive offer, Shyam bought enough packets to make 6,000 laddus. So this month, when we say during the festive offer, so now this criteria will come into picture. For Shyam, it is given to me again, he will make 6,000 laddus only. So we need to find the number of packets purchased by him and the cost that is being incurred by him. Right? So we are required the ratio of amount spent by Shyam to the amount spent by Ram. Right? So Shyam bought enough packets to make 6,000 laddus. And I know that 1 kg will give me 100 laddus. And x kg will give me 100x laddus. As I am going to add 20% extra material in each packet. So, can I say the quantity required to make this much of laddus? Right? Obviously, the number of packets will reduce now. Right, Nitesh. All right. So he will definitely take 1.2 times this value. Guys, is it done? So initially, 60 packets were sufficient to make 6,000 laddus because he has to add 20% extra. Right. He has to add 20% extra because of the same, his consumption will go high. So can you think of in how many packets he can make only 6,000 laddus? Answer nahi, Bhargav, answer nahi. Abhi just answer this part, right? Because now he will be, yes, Abhijit, yes. Not on YouTube. This is purely for Grade Up app. Only for the students of Grade Up, not for YouTube. Alright, so I'm not focusing on answer. My question right now is, so 60 packets were sufficient to make 6,000 laddus. Now we need to focus on how many packets are required to make 6,000 laddus. This is the question. Be quick, guys. Tell me. Answer pe sabhi bhag rahe ho. It is already given to me. 1 kg of laddu mix packet can be used to make 100 laddus. 1 किलो से एक पैकेट जो है तुम्हारा 1 केजी का, उससे 100 लड्डूज बन सकते हैं. नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू ऐड 20% एक्स्ट्रा मटेरियल इन ईच पैकेट. राइट, यू आर गोइंग टू ऐड 20% एक्स्ट्रा मटेरियल. क्या नंबर ऑफ पैकेट सेम होंगे? वाय सिमरन 3:4. माई क्वेश्चन इज वाय 3:4. यू गाइज आर स्ट्रेटवेज जंपिंग टू द सोल्यूशन, राइट? डू नॉट जंप टू द सोल्यूशन स्ट्रेटवेज. मेरा क्वेश्चन समझने की कोशिश करो. एक सिंपल सा मेरा क्वेश्चन है. तुम 1 kg में 6,000 लड्डू बनाते हो, इट इज अगेन गिवन टू मी, श्याम हैज टू मेक, राइट, श्याम बॉट एन ऑफ पैकेट्स टू मेक 6,000 लड्डू, 6,000 लड्डू ही बनाने हैं उसने अभी भी, वो 50 पैकेट से 6,000 लड्डू कैसे बना लेगा, टेल मी दिस, 50 पैकेट से तो लाइक 5,000 लड्डू बनेंगे, 6,000 कैसे बनाएगा। हाँ, 50 पैकेट्स पर बॉर्ड बाय शाम, दैट इज समथिंग वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड, सो द टोटल नंबर ऑफ पैकिंग्स विल नॉट बी द सेम, इस चीज का सभी ने ध्यान रखना है, राइट। सो श्याम विल परचेज 50 पैकेट्स विच विल एनेबल हिम टू मेक 5,000 लड्डूज, ये क्लियर है, ही विल मेक 50 पैकेट्स विच विल एनेबल हिम टू मेक 5,000 लड्डूज, बिकॉज इन दिस केस ही विल बी एडिंग 20% एक्स्ट्रा, सो इफेक्टिवली टोटल नंबर ऑफ लड्डूज विल बी 6,000, बट बाई यूजिंग 60 पैकेट्स, राइट, बाई यूजिंग 60 पैकेट्स, दिस इज हाउ द पैकिंग इज टू बी डन, राइट। सो इट इज नॉट 50 पैकेट्स, प्लीज कीप दैट इन माइंड, राइट। सो इन इन केस ऑफ राम द कॉस्ट पर पैकेट गिवन टू मी इज 150, बट इन केस ऑफ श्याम कॉस्ट पर पैकेट विल डेफिनेटली इंक्रीज नाउ बिकॉज 20% एक्स्ट्रा मटीरियल इज एडेड, सो द कॉस्ट विल डेफिनेटली जंप अप, इजंट इट। ये देख लो क्लियर है सभी को। सो अगर वो 50 पैकेट्स परचेज करके, तुम लोग कंफ्यूज हो रहे हो, अगर वो 50 पैकेट्स परचेज करके 5,000 लड्डू बनाता, राइट, सो इन दैट केस उसका भी पर पैकेट जो कॉस्ट था दैट विल बी 150 ओनली, सो द कॉस्ट विल बी 50 × 150, बट लड्डू तो वो 6,000 बना रहा है ना, सो ही इज एडिंग मोर लड्डूज पर पैकेट, जो भी उसका पैकेट का साइज है उसमें वो 20% एक्स्ट्रा लड्डू डाल रहा है, हाँ डिस्काउंट पे आते हैं ना यार, बाद में डिस्काउंट पे आते हैं, ठीक है, इस चीज को समझो, राइट, क्योंकि वो 20% एक्स्ट्रा लड्डू डाल रहा है हर पैकेट में, तो ऑब्वियसली उसका हर पैकेट का कॉस्ट विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, राइट। सो इंस्टेड ऑफ 150, नाउ कैन आई से इफ आई इंक्रीज इट बाय 20%, इट कम्स आउट टू बी 180, इसके ऊपर वो डिस्काउंट दे रहा है 10% का, राइट। सो इसके ऊपर अगर 10% का आप डिस्काउंट दोगे तो इट इज एज गुड एज 9,000 के ऊपर 10% का डिस्काउंट दिया, बिकॉज स्टिल 50 × 180 कम्स आउट टू बी 9,000, लड्डू 6,000 बनाने के लिए उसको 60 पैकेट मटेरियल तो खरीदना ही होगा, वो 50 पैकेट्स नहीं बना रहा, एक पैकेट से 100 लड्डू बना रहा है, ये चीज समझो, ट्वेंटी परसेंट एक्स्ट्रा मटेरियल डाल रहा है इन ईच पैकेट, राइट। लड्डू तो टोटल 6,000 ही है ना, नंबर ऑफ पैकेट विल रिड्यूस, सो दैट्स व्हाई कॉस्टिंग ऑफ ईच पैकेट विल इंक्रीज, एंड ही इज ऑल्सो ऑफरिंग अ 10% डिस्काउंट, वन केजी ऑफ लड्डू मिक्स, यार लड्डू मिक्स मीन्स इट्स अ रेडीमेड मटेरियल, बस तुमने वो 1 kg पैकेट लिया और उससे 100 लड्डू बना दिए, दैट्स इट, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन, राइट। तुमने 1 kg पैकेट लिया और उससे 100 लड्डूज बना दिए, राम ने भी 6,000 लड्डू बनाए, श्याम ने भी 6,000 लड्डू बनाए, जब दोनों 6,000 लड्डू बना रहे हैं, दोनों को 60 kg 60 kg के तो पैकेट लेने ही पड़ेंगे ना, तभी वो बनेगा, इजंट इट। चलो तुम लोग काफी इसमें ना परेशान हो रहे हो, लीव दिस क्वेश्चन, इसे मैं फिर किसी दिन करवाता हूं विद अ फ्रेश माइंड, सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू दिस, इसको एक बार प्लीज सभी ट्राई करना, ठीक है, विद अ फ्रेश माइंड एक बार ट्राई करना। सो अभी आई थिंक सभी लोग बिल्कुल इधर उधर घूम रहे हैं. लेट्स सॉल्व दिस. फोर वुमेन एंड वन मैन प्लान अ रॉबरी एंड डिसाइड टू शेयर द स्पॉयल्स इक्वली. सो लेट्स से W1, W2, W3, W4, W rather M are the five person. So सभी ने total amount equally distribute करना है. So let it be XX, XXX. So the total robbery amount is 5X. However, on the night of the robbery, the man falls sick. While the robbery is successful, the man gets only half of the share he was entitled to. So he was entitled to X, but he got only X by 2 finally. Then the ratio of amount of money shared by the woman to the original share they were entitled to is. Now, X by 2 is given to a man, right, out of 5X. So remaining amount will be 5X minus X by 2, which comes out to be 10 minus 1, 9X by 2, which will be divided equally among these four women. Right, so 9x by 2 divided by 4 comes out to be 9x by 8 for each and every woman. Now the question says the ratio of amount of money shared by the women, right, so this is shared by the women to the original share. So 9x by 8 is to x comes out to be a share of 9 is to 8. So guys, please check it out. Here the answer comes out to be C. Okay, it's fine. So this is quite easily understood. Let's move on to next. The economy of Siberia consists of exactly two industries, mining and manufacturing. Harish, अभी रहने दे उस क्वेश्चन को. लड्डू वाला क्वेश्चन मैं कल करवा दूंगा दोबारा से, फ्रेश माइंड के साथ छोड़ दे. कोई इतना टेंशन थोड़े ना है, लड़ना थोड़ी है क्वेश्चन से हमने. लेट्स मूव ऑन. यू नो आई नेवर स्किप अ क्वेश्चन, बट ठीक है अभी उसमें थोड़ा सा अगर सभी का ट्यूनिंग नहीं बैठ रहा बाद में कर लेंगे. राइट, सो देयर आर टू इंडस्ट्रीज, माइनिंग एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. इट वाज एक्सपेक्टेड दैट द इकोनॉमी वुड ग्रो बाय 18% इफ माइनिंग ग्रू बाय 10% एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग बाय 20%. सो योर इकोनॉमी विल ग्रो बाय 20%. However, if manufacturing grew only by 10%, then for the economy to still grow by 18%, mining needs to grow by what percent? So the economy of Siberia consists of exactly two industries, which means, first of all, we need to find the relation, mathematical relation between these three. So can you guys tell me? समीर छोड़ दे अभी उसे, आंसर से लेना देना नहीं है. राइट, वी शुड बी ऑन द सेम पेज टू कम अप विद द यू नो कंक्लूजन. अभी वो नहीं आया, कल करेंगे उसे. हाँ, दैट इकोनॉमी इज 18 बाय मिस्टेक, आई रोट 20. यस, इट इज 18 ओनली. सो व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन दीज थ्री? That is 18. I rectified. So what is the relation between economy, mining, manufacturing? Kya mathematical relation lekar chalenge? Jaldi batao. So can I say whatever is the revenue earned from mining plus the revenue earned from manufacturing, that will be your economy. Is it done? जो भी earning finally mining से होगा, जो भी earning manufacturing से होगा. Vikram, I will not say direct relationship. Because it is not product of mining into manufacturing equals economy. Why allegation, Harish? Yeah, that is there. Now, when it comes to, he says there are exactly two industries. One is mining, other is manufacturing, right? It means there is no relation between mining and manufacturing. उसने दोनों को पहले ही अलग कर दिया है, ठीक है? So they are not going to be dependent entities एक दूसरे पे. विक्रम, दोनों को अलग कर दिया उसने, राइट? सो लेट्स से अगर माइनिंग से मैंने रुपीस एक्स बना रहा था, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग से वाई बना रहा था, सो इकोनॉमी में बन रहा था तुम्हारा एक्स प्लस वाई, राइट? सो इट इंक्रीज बाय 10%, नाउ इट बिकम्स 1.1x, दिस बिकम्स 1.2y, बट नाउ दिस इज ओनली 1.18 टाइम्स एक्स प्लस वाई, right? So we need to find the relation between x and y out of this. That will enable me to find the relation here, right? So here it comes out to be 1.1x plus 1.2y equals 1.18 times x plus y. So 1.18x minus 1.1x comes out to be 0.08x, which equals 1.2y minus 1.18y, which is 0.02y. So the ratio between x and y comes out to be 1/4. Now the very same thing can be done with the help of allegation also. So from mining and from manufacturing, we are given increase of 10% and 20%. Economy is giving me average increase of 18%. So we can say the mining and manufacturing values are in the ratio, difference of these two is 2, difference of these two is 8, which is 1:4. Now in second part, this value is to be found. This given to me is 10, this is 18, and I know they are in the ratio 1:4, so they will remain in the ratio 1:4, x and y. Now 18 minus 10 is 8. If this value is 8, so this value must be 4 × 8, 32, right? So kis mein se 18 subtract karoge, 32 bane, so 32 plus 18, this value comes out to be 50%. Hence the correct answer option is C, right? That's what I asked, Harish, kaise karoge aur kyun karoge. Theek hai, so first of all we need to understand the relation, basic relation between mining and manufacturing. Can be solved with the help of equation, can be solved with the help of allegation also. I hope it is clear to each and every student. So exam mein whatever strikes you first, just use that particular method and move on, right? So that's why I picked both the cases of equation as well as of allegation. Although allegation is always easier to implement, right? But samajh dono ka aana chahiye. Okay, so let's solve it. Here he says, figure 1 consists of a circle C with center O. OA and OB are perpendicular to each other. So this given to me is 90 degree. So angle subtended by an arc at the center of the circle is always twice of the angle subtended at the circumference. So if this is 90, this angle must be 45 degree. The area of triangle AOB is 32. So if I consider OA to be R, OB to be R, so its area will be half of R square, which is 32. So R square comes out to be 64. Or we can say R comes out to be a square root of 64, which is 8. So if OA is 8, OB is 8, this angle being 90 degree, AB comes out to be 8 root 2. So by applying Pythagoras theorem. Now he says if AD equal BD, so we are given AD and BD are equal, the area of triangle ABD is, so we are required area of this entire triangle. Right, so in order to solve this, we are required either all the three sides, and then we will apply the concept of Heron's formula. That is one way of doing it, right? Or we can also use, because triangle ADB is isosceles triangle, If I drop a perpendicular here, right, it will definitely pass through O. And this OD is going to be again your circumradius whose length is 8. So this is going to be perpendicular here. So we are required this much of length. So that will enable me with the height of entire triangle. So agar mereko triangle ka height mil gaya, still job will be done. As we know, in triangle AOB, this angle is 90. And these two sides are equal. So these two angles are also equal. So they must be 45, 45. Now in triangle OB, I am writing this point as X. In triangle OBX, this is 45. This is 90. This must be 45, which means these two sides are equal. And in isosceles triangle, perpendicular always bisect the opposite side AB. So this BX must be 4 root 2. So this is also going to be 4 root 2. So height of the triangle comes out to be 8 plus 4 root 2. Base is 8 root 2. So area will be half of height into base. So 2 times 4 is 8, get cancelled out. Let's open the bracket, right? Or we can take even value common depending on kaisa option banta hai, right? So 8 4s are 32 root 2 plus 4 4s are 16 into 2 will be 32. So if we take 32 common, it becomes 1 plus root 2. So the correct answer option will be B. Right, Samir. So please check it out. I hope it is clear to each and every student. Right, Samir. That can also be used. Okay, so let's move on. Here it says these three values are in AP, then X is equal to. So if these three values are in AP, then twice of middle equals sum of these two. So twice of this gives me 2 will go to the power. So we can rewrite this thing as log 2 raised to power X minus 5 whole square to the base 3 equal. When these two are added and base is same, the values will be multiplied. So it will be 2 into 2 raised to power x minus 7 by 2. So now in this case, because base is same, so log can be eliminated. It results in 2 raised to power x minus 5 whole square equal twice of 2 raised to power x minus 7 by 2. So let's open the bracket on the right hand side and use answer options to solve it. So 2 into 7 by 2 comes out to be 7. If we take 2 as a value here, so this 2 into 2 square is 8, and 8 minus 7 is 1, 2 square minus 5 is minus 1 square is 1, both are equal. But if I take x as 2 in this case, 2 square is 4, minus 1 is minus 1, minus 5 is minus 1, and log of negative values is not defined, so option A is ruled out. When we use option B, which is 3, so 2 cube is 8, 8 minus 5 is 3, and 3 square is 9. Here it will be 2 into 2 cube, which is 8 into 2, 16, and 16 minus 7 is again 9. So the correct answer comes out to be option B. Or we can also say the moment 2 is ruled out, all the three options got ruled out because they all had 2. Right? So the answer comes out to be option B. Kajal, it's B, not D. So 2 is not the answer, right? Because 2 will make this value negative. 2 square minus 5 is minus 1. So that becomes negative. Okay, so let's move on. Here it says in the sequence 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, so on, where n consecutive terms have the value n. The 150th term is. So in this case, 1 is there 1 times, 2 is there 2 times, 3 is there 3 times, 4 is there 4 times, then 5 will be there 5 times, and so on. So I have to reach 150th term of this series. In order to reach there, mereko karna kya hai basically? Inhe add hi karna hai. यहां तक एक टर्म हो गया, यहां तक तीन टर्म्स हो गए, यहां तक 1 + 2 + 3 सिक्स टर्म्स हो गए, यहां तक 10 टर्म्स हो गए, यहां तक 15 टर्म्स हो गए. सो आई नो सम ऑफ फर्स्ट एन नेचुरल नंबर्स इज एन इनटू एन प्लस 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 2. सो आई जस्ट नीड टू चेक टिल व्हाट नंबर ऑल द डिजिट्स विल बी टेकन केयर ऑफ. वी जस्ट नीड टू कीप इन माइंड आफ्टर 9, 10, 11, 12 ऑल आर गोइंग टू बी टू डिजिट नंबर्स. राइट, उससे पहले खत्म होता है या उसके बाद, दैट इज समथिंग वी नीड टू चेक. राइट, सो हियर एज इट इज गिवन टू मी, n consecutive terms have the value n. So 10 will be written 10 times, 11 will be written 11 times, 12 will be written 12 times, and so on. So we just need to use hit and trial to find value of n, which will take the sum closer to 150. And options here gives us very clear cut picture about ki hume kahan tak study karna. Like if I take n as 14, so it will be 14 into 15 by 2. 7 get cancelled out, comes out to be 105. Still there is a lot of gap. If I take n as 15, 15 into 16 by 2 comes out to be 120. Still there is a lot of gap. If we take n as 16, it comes out to be 136. Still there is a gap. Right? But if I take n as 17, in that case, it comes out to be 153, which will definitely cross this limit. Right? So up to this mark, I know when n is 16, so 16 must be written 16 times. Right? Here, 1 was written 1 times. Here, up to 2. राइट, सो मैंने एंड पिक किया है हर किसी का, प्लीज कीप दैट इन माइंड. सो व्हेन आई एम सेइंग 3, इट मींस 2 कंप्लीट हो गया है. व्हेन आई एम सेइंग 6, इट मींस 3 कंप्लीट हो चुका है. व्हेन आई एम सेइंग n इज 4, तो मेरा 4 कंप्लीट हो चुका है. राइट, व्हेन आई एम सेइंग n इज 5, तो मेरा 5 का सीरीज कंप्लीट हो चुका है. सो व्हेन आई एम सेइंग n इज 16, तो 16 का सीरीज कंप्लीट हो चुका है. नेक्स्ट सीरीज जो शुरू होगा, इट विल बी ऑफ 17. सो द 150th टर्म मस्ट बी 17 in this case. Right, Ayush? Khushbu, please check it out. It's not 18, it's 17. Is it clear, everyone? Right. Okay, so let's move on. Here he says, if 1 minus p is a root of the quadratic equation, then its roots are. So there is something wrong with this information. If 1 minus p is a root, so it must be one of the answer option which is not there. So there is something wrong with the question. Leave it. Let's move on to next one. Here it says the number of different 6 digit numbers, the sum of whose digits is odd is. Okay. So the number of 6 digit numbers will start from 1 lakh, and in this case sum of the digits is 1, which is odd. If I will take next number, which is 1 lakh 1, sum is 2, which comes out to be even. If I take next number, which is 1 lakh 2, sum comes out to be 3, which is odd. So whenever we are going to study all the numbers, you will find one number is odd, one is even, one is odd, one is even. That is always true. So half of the numbers will be there whose sum of digits will be odd, and rest half will be having even sum of digits. So total number of 6 digit numbers we know is 9 into 10 raised to power 5. So half of this will be the required answer. So it comes out to be 45 into 10 raised to power 4, which is option D. So please check it out. This is a very, very beautiful question. Is it done? A very basic question, but a very technical question. This is something usually people do not look after. Navet, total number of 6 digit numbers when you will make For this position, zero cannot come. There are 9 possibilities. For all other positions, number of possibilities are 10. So it is 9 into 10 raised to power 5. Is it done, Naved? Right. So we are getting a bit late. So there are a couple of questions which are required a lot of solution. So let's keep it this much, guys, for today. I have another class also scheduled, right? So we will discuss these questions later on, or you can try them. So now there is important announcement that you guys can save big on CAT and MBA green card. There is a 6-month validity in just ₹1,299 and 3 months validity, which is available in ₹799. Ongoing and upcoming courses at GridUp right now. When we talk about CAT 2021, third batch has started on 9th of November. So all CAT 2021 aspirants can join in this batch. It is a comprehensive course wherein each and everything is covered from very basics till advanced. CAT and other MBA exams 2020, right? So this is for 2020, this year only. So all these are non-CAT exams, right, which also need GK. So this batch we have just started. This is again second batch which we have started, right? GK and current affair course is also going simultaneously for the same. So for non-CAT aspirants, this will be a very, very helpful course. So all CAT 2021 aspirants has to join for 18 months program, wherein for CAT 2020 or non-CAT 2020, students has to enroll for 6 or 3 months program. So this is our team at GridUp. So all the faculty members are 99.9 plus percentile almost, and 6 of us are 100 percentilers. So we wish you all very best. Please keep practicing topic-wise quizzes, keep attending live classes. Thank you, guys. Thanks a lot. We'll catch up with you tomorrow. Yes, we have done a lot of sessions on this year. Ball sessions ho gaye ispe. We are expecting 60 or 75 questions this year. Right? Now only 10 days are left. Abhi expected questions ko chodo na yaar. Abhi let's focus on getting score. Theek hai? Abhi to bas score batorne ki baat karo. So we are going to focus on now maximizing the score. That's it. Right, Ayaz? Theek hai, guys. Milte hain aapko kal. Right, same time. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Riti. Thank you. Right. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Good night, guys. Good night.